Thanks, Jonathan. Another surprise announcement involving the 6th Congressional District. Democrat Jim Graves says that he won't be running. And this comes just 2 days after Congresswoman Michelle Bachmann said that she would not be seeking re-election. 2 days ago, we sat down with Graves, and he said at the time that Bachmann's move wouldn't change his game plan. Take a listen.
You know, the message is the same. We weren't running against Michelle Bachmann. We were running for the people of the 6th District.
And now here's the statement that he released today. This was never about Jim Graves. This was about challenging the ineffective leadership and extremist ideology of Michelle Bachmann on behalf of those that she represents. As of Wednesday, that goal was accomplished. Quite the turn of events. And joining me now is a panel of political analysts. We have Professor Larry Jacobs from the University of Minnesota and, of course, Catherine Pearson, also from the U. Larry, I'm going to start with you. I mean, did you expect this to happen right after Bachmann announced what she announced?
I was surprised when Bachmann pulled out, not surprised by Jim Graves. Jim Graves' best chance was against the wounded Bachmann. And what he started to see is that the fundraising capacity he would have, the national contributors, particularly from the national congressional committee, was going to dry up. And for that reason, he was going to put a lot of time in, a lot of heartache, and not have the funds he would need.
And Catherine, you've kind of felt the same thing. You're surprised about Bachmann, but not necessarily Graves. Explain that.
That's absolutely right. The 6th District is the most Republican district in Minnesota. Mitt Romney garnered 56% in the 2012 presidential in the 6th District. And so Bachmann's best shot was indeed against an incumbent who was besieged by the potential for scandal. There are several investigations going on. And no matter what those turn up, she was clearly wounded. There was national interest. And he came within a point and a half of defeating her in 2012. So without her, it's much harder to imagine that he could defeat a Republican that would be nominated to run in 2014.
So is he lying to us 2 days ago when he came in and did all these interviews and said, oh, it's not about Bachmann, it's about the people? Was he just lying to us?
No, I think he really believed that. It's just he spent some time with probably some of his campaign advisors. They looked at the numbers. They probably got some phone calls from people he thought he had a commitment from saying, we're rethinking our strategy. And so he rethought his strategy. This is clearly damage control. He'd like to exit, go back to his business.
Yeah, I mean, you talk about the future of Jim Graves. I mean, is his political career over? Does he even care about his political career now? I mean, is he more focused on his business aspirations and his business that he runs?
Yeah, I mean, he's always been a strong businessman. That was certainly the credentials he took to the race in 2012. And so why would he want to spend the next 17 months trying to get into politics when he hasn't, you know, been trying to get into politics for his life's ambition? He's been a businessman. And 2014 is going to be a tough year for Democrats. It's a midterm cycle. The party of the president typically does worse in midterm elections. And so Democrats in liberal groups are going to be spending their money where they can get the biggest bang for their buck. And the 6th District of Minnesota without Michelle Bachmann isn't that place.
Let's talk about the future of the 6th Congressional District. Obviously, a lot of Republicans have said they want to run. I mean, the list is like 8 or 9, something like that. What about Democrats now, too?
This is not a great location for Democrats. I think the Democrats will be back to where they were before, trying to find a quality candidate willing to go into, as Catherine said, a solidly Republican, conservative-leaning district. The real action is going to be on the Republican side. Clearly, the party would like to find someone like an Eric Paulson who can win and then return that district to being a safe, reliable Republican win.
Yeah, some of these names, I mean, State Senator Michelle Benson, former State Rep Phil Kroenke, State Rep Peggy Scott, State Rep Matt Dean. I mean, the list is growing. Do you feel like there is a front runner right now, or are they just going to have to sort that out in the coming months?
They're going to have to sort that out. But one difference that Graves dropping out of the race will make is that with Graves in the race is a moderate. Republicans had more of an incentive to nominate a moderate. And without Graves, and potentially without a strong DFL candidate, Republicans may not feel that impetus to really pick someone who'd be centrist and battle out over those independent votes, as it is such a Republican district.
Yeah. Well, it's definitely shifted in just a matter of days.
Yeah.
It sure has. I think this is going to be one of these races, though, where Republican Party will want a solid candidate. There are a good number of independents here, and as you look back at the history of this race, you'll see that the independent candidate has done okay, 10 to 15% among candidates who are not that well known. I think, you know, someone like Senator Benson or Representative Matt Dean, those are the kind of candidates that the Republican Party leadership would love to see get the nomination.
All right, Larry and Catherine, thanks so much for coming in. We appreciate your insight on this topic. Eric.